Well, I want to show you a little gizmo I made to chase threads on common size bolts. I realized that all the common sizes from 10, 24, quarter 20, 5/16, 3/8, half inch, all have the same 1-inch die. And I got really tired of chasing threads because I use these bolts a lot for welding, where they get left outside and they get corroded, and so I just need to chase the thread. Sometimes I use the wire wheel, but sometimes the wire wheel doesn't get everything completely clean in here, so I want to chase these threads again. And then recently I was doing a little project where I had some sleeve pipes, and I wanted to, so I ground points on the end of all these grade 8 bolts, and then I wanted to make sure that I chased that burr off the end. And so I want to just show you this. So I took a half inch drive socket that I had, you know, that I never use, and this is, you know, one of those quick things that goes a hex drive that goes in a cordless drill, and this is a star point. It's not a hex thing, but like I said, I never used this, so it didn't really matter. And so what I did is I just took in three places where it would be on those flats. I took my little V block, and I carefully marked out, and I just drilled and tapped holes in there. But before I did that, I took a little piece of pipe, and I was going to use a bronze bushing, but it really didn't work right. So I just took a piece of pipe and cut it with my pipe cutter. And then I had to grind on the outside a little bit with the belt sander, and then just check for squareness. And then I have this down in here. I just slip that in. It's a little bit of a tight fit. And now I can just pop any one of these dies in here. Well, I got to get it to where it's going to line up right with the set screws. And there you go. So now you got a way that you can chase threads with a cordless drill and just get after it and do it really quickly. So a lot of times I have, here's thread locker on this. So let me start at the bottom, and I'll just go ahead and put that 1024 in here first. Of course, you know, you want the large side part of the die up facing the top, and you just kind of hold it down with your finger and lock these guys down. And these are the 1024 set screws that I had. They're a little long. I don't have any other ones, and I just haven't remembered to get any the next time I go to the bolt place. And so they look a little funny sticking out, but I don't care. They hold it in place perfect. So put it in your cordless drill, put it on slow speed, and in this case I'm going to just hold this with this ball driver, and I'm going to put just a little touch of, I don't want to use cutting fluid, I'm just going to put a little bit of oil on here, but I want it, this will cut those, cut that goop of the thread lock off of here in just a second. So now that's perfectly clean, and I had a little 1024 nut here. Where did it go? Those guys are so little. Here it is, underneath that cap. So now this is a perfectly clean threads, and done just really quickly. So so there's a 1024. Let's just go ahead and switch out, and we'll go to something else. About this 3/8. I got a bunch of this 3/8 stuff here. 3/8. So of course the bigger part of the taper is of course pointed up. That set screw's not all the way out. That's it. What do we do with it? 3/8/16. Okay, here it is. Oh, I almost put that 3/8. What was it? I think I had a 3/8 20. Yeah, I had that 3/8 24. So yeah, that would have been bad. So this is a 3/8 16. That's what all these bolts are, which is a size I use all the time. I weld nuts onto things with 3/8 bolts. It's a really good size for creating lock handles and such. And I'm just gonna go ahead and hold this. So that's something that I welded with right there. Let me put a little bit of oil there. Clean it up. And it'll chase down pretty far before it starts pushing that out. You can see it's starting to push it out. But you know, if you had a situation where you needed more, you could always just do the same thing with a deep well socket. Just rig up a deep well socket. But this is what I had, and so I just, you know, made it work, and it's working for me perfect. But there you go. Let's do another one. This one's really messed up. This has got, looks like weld goop and rust on it. Probably enough oil on that die right now. Probably not. Let's give it a little drink here. Clean as a whistle. And you know, if you have an all thread like this, so this piece of all thread was cut. I've got that nylock on there, and so that piece of all thread was cut at the end. So a lot of times you have that burr. You grind it, you just run your tap down it like that. Now you're done. You're ready to move on. Here's one that had a lot of, I think that's weld and also thread lock on here. Oh yeah, that was all thread lock. That stuff gets hard. A lot of times it doesn't want to clean out with the wire wheel. But that is just, you know, that's just ready. You know, I try to reuse bolts when I can. You know, I'm not building the space shuttle or anything, so I'm not worried about like metal fatigue. A lot of times it's just shop fixtures and stuff, and you can reuse a grade 8 bolt, you know, a number of times in my opinion without worrying. There's one, there's a bunch of thread lock on there. That is just, you know, that is such a nightmare to try to get rid of. Let's deal with that. That's going to push it all the way out. Like I said, it'd be real easy to do the same thing with a deep well socket. You know, you just have to make a little bit of correction with your plug down there, your spacer. But look, that got all of that. That was just a mess. So that's just gonna, you know, fighting threads and nuts is just, oh man, you when you're trying to get some work done, it's just a pain. So this is really a good way to do it. This one's a mess. This one's got thread lock on it. Same size. Yeah, let's switch out one more, and we'll do one more size. Got a half inch 13. Big boys here. I got one that's really, this one's really rusted here. Found this out under my work table. Man, I know nothing's going on that. I mean, there's no way you're gonna, you just be fighting that like crazy. That's what I'm talking about. You got all the stuff in your shop already. You don't even need to spend any money on it, you know. Just spend 20 minutes and knock this out. It'll last you forever.